What's up, champs? I'm Mr. Leaning Versus, and welcome back to the channel, and welcome to my final video of 2023 to my PSN Platinum Trophies collection. This is an update. The first ever video I did 5.5 months ago was a very similar video to this. I plan on doing two of these a year, so every 6 months to update you guys and see where I'm at with platinums and trophies. So the last time I did this video, I was actually trophy level 597. I'm now sitting at 624. I had 206 platinums. Now I've got 249. And for total trophies, I've gone from 17,195 to 18,905. It's been a pretty damn good few months for the for my trophy collection. All right, so in the last video, I left off on Tacoma. Grey Hill incident. Didn't take me too long, this one. It was pretty short. I think I actually got it done in one day, maybe two. Nothing too crazy with this one. Just follow a guide for any of the missable stuff and the collectibles. Overall.
Oh, my days. Are you freaking serious with that? Ooh, there it is. Gold trophy. Invader. I know we should pop that beauty.
Well, there's my reaction to getting the platinum. Super average game. But I have an interest in aliens. Aliens always intrigue me. So any game with aliens and stuff like that, I'm probably going to check it out. So yeah, this one, Abductee, the platinum, super short, super easy, really funny dialogue as well. Unintentionally funny dialogue because it's the voice acting is not great. Next, we've got Spirit of the North, another short one. I think I kind of did a couple of short videos, short games. It just eased myself in, I guess you would say. So we got there, Master of Light. The ending of the game I wasn't the biggest fan of because you needed to collect all these souls and then find them all at the last area, which I wasn't a big fan of. But the game overall was pretty cool. I love the setting. Definitely check this one out if you want a short, relaxing platinum. Moving on, Fast and the Furious Spy Racers, Rise of Shifter, another video that I did, another short one. Nothing too crazy with this one. Basically just do some races, play through the story, and then repeat a couple of races to get coins to grab all of the collectibles and stuff. The Amicia, this one is a Souls-like, and I actually think it's a pretty good Souls-like game. Most of the Souls-likes are pretty bad, but this one's a decent one. And as for getting the platinum and the trophies,
let's go.
You can see there, I'm pretty excited about finally pulling off the win and getting the platinum, because there's one trophy in particular. Most of the other trophies are pretty easily done. There's nothing too crazy. This one, You Shall Not Pass, is really difficult. It sounds easy. Just simply beat the first phase of the boss in the tutorial. It sounds like it'd be easy, but it's pretty freaking difficult. I was really happy though when I finally got it done. But yeah, check this one out. It's really good if you like Souls-likes. Nobunaga's Ambition, I haven't got around to playing this one yet, but I do plan on doing it in the future. Whether I make a video or not, I'm not sure. We'll see about that one. Stranded Deep, if I remember right, this one I kind of cheesed. I don't think you can do it anymore because I think it's been patched now. From what I remember, they brought an update out that allowed you to play co-op. If you joined a co-op player that had trophies you didn't, it would auto pop those trophies for you. So I basically just went into servers hoping that I would join someone that also had the trophies. And because a lot of people were doing this, there was a lot of trophies going around. So it was pretty easy to get. I think I need something like half an hour to find someone that had all the trophies. Unfortunately, it doesn't work anymore to my knowledge. They took it out of the game, so you can't do it anymore. But yeah, nothing too crazy with that one. Far Cry 3 Classic Edition. Played this one on the channel. I absolutely love Far Cry 3. I platinumed the PS3 version of Far Cry 3 as well. This one was pretty much the exact same, but even easier because there were no online stuff to do. Whereas in the original, there was a couple of online trophies, if I remember right. Yeah, really fun. Absolutely recommend playing and going for the platinum in Far Cry 3 Classic Edition. Borderlands 3, I've got the PS4 version platinum. So I do plan on going back and doing the PS5 version of Borderlands 3 and along with all of the DLC in the future. So yeah, that should be put into a video at some point. Assassin's Creed 2. my favorite Assassin's Creed game. All fairness though, I haven't played a lot of the new ones. I do plan on going through and getting the platinum in all of the Assassin's Creed games. I've only really managed two so far. So still got a long ways to go for getting the platinum in all the Assassin's Creeds. Assassin's Creed 2, pretty much the usual Assassin's Creed affair. You know, get the collectibles, go to the vantage points, uncover the map, the usual stuff, and then get 100 feathers, which was a little bit tedious. So yeah, really good game though. Dragon Ball Kakarot. This one, if I remember right, was an auto pop. I'd already platinumed the PS4 version. And then the PS5 version come out and you could just auto pop the trophies. So that's what I did for this one. So yeah, I literally just went to the main menu, downloaded my PS4 save, and that popped all of the trophies, including the Dragon Ball Master Platinum trophy. So yeah, that was easy. Hogwarts Legacy. I went over this one a little bit on my PlayStation wrap-up video. This one, as a game, if you just play through this game just naturally, it's really fun. As a platinum journey, like getting the platinum in this game, it's just really tedious. There's way too many collectibles, and to make it even worse, I think it's okay now, but for the longest time it was really glitchy. Stuff didn't count, collectibles didn't count, and then you also need to play through like the first 2 hours of the game multiple times for the different houses. So you can see I needed to play through the first like 2 hours of the game as Ravenclaw, Gryffindor, and Slytherin. I'd obviously already done my first playthrough, so that's just an extra 6 hours of playing through the beginning of the game again, and it's really annoying. So yeah, as a platinum, it's not that great, but the game itself is really fun. Sackboy A Big Adventure. Now this one I'm pretty proud of, because the String It Together trophy, this sucker right here, is insane. This trophy, I was not expecting it to be so difficult. When I got into this, I was expecting just a fun, chill, relaxing platinum, and although it was all of those things, I absolutely loved my time with this game. It's amazing. I definitely recommend playing it. That final trophy, String It Together, is one insane headache. It's pretty freaking difficult. If you want to go and watch the video on that, you'll see my reaction to finally getting that trophy. But yeah, really, really enjoyed Sackboy A Big Adventure. Atlas Fallen. This one was really average, if I'm being honest. It wasn't a bad game. It was just very generic, very forgetful. I did make a video on this one as well, so check that one out if you're interested. Moving Out 2. I plan on doing Moving Out 1 and 2. Just haven't got around to it yet. Lego Harry Potter Collection, years 1 through 4. This one I was kind of worried about playing because a lot of the trophies can glitch and bug out. I think I had an issue with one of them, but ended up being able to fix it in the end. A little bit stressful to go into, but I didn't really have most of the issues. And if you kind of look online and check the issues beforehand so you can avoid them, it's not too bad. Do still need to do the years 5 through 6 or 7, I think it is. This is the usual stuff though for a Lego game. You know, get all the ranks, all the collectibles, the golden Lego bricks. You know the deal. If you've played the Lego games and you've got a platinum in a Lego game, you know what the deal is with that one. PUBG Battlegrounds. I still haven't made the video for this one. This one's been done for the longest time, and for whatever reason I still haven't got around to editing it and putting it on the channel. This one is pretty difficult and takes quite a long time. Fortunately, these days it's a lot easier than it used to be, because there's now like a training mode where you can play against bots.
Oh my god,
so
Master Assassin, kill 1,000 players.
You can see my reaction there to finally pulling off the platinum. Pretty easy, it just takes a while to get the 1,000 kills. Moving on to Far Cry 5. Now this was one that I was actually really surprised, because I've heard a lot of negative things about Far Cry 5. And honestly, I really liked it. Like, I really, really liked Far Cry 5. The gameplay I liked more than Far Cry 3. The story was pretty good as well, to be honest. Like, yeah, I just really liked this game. I'd say Far Cry 3 and 5 are about the same for me, how much I enjoyed them. The biggest issue with this one, if you're going for the platinum, however, is these online trophies, and they're all just crap. There's no real like way of getting around it. They're all really crappy trophies and they're not fun. The play the arcade hero mode, it's absolutely terrible. I played the featured maps and they were still bad. And then you've got like the online ones as well. So kill 100 players in multiplayer, reach level 20 in the arcade mode, win 10 featured maps. Like, if it weren't for this multiplayer trophies at the end, I would have enjoyed the whole like platinum journey for this one, but because of the multiplayer trophies, it kind of ruined it a little bit because they were so bad. Overall, it's just I really, really enjoyed it a lot more, like I said, than I thought I would. Not got any of the DLC trophies yet. I don't know if you guys would be interested. Let me know in the comments if you'd be interested in seeing me go back and basically get all of the DLC trophies as well. Armored Core. This one I really, really enjoyed as well. I didn't find it as difficult as some people did. When I looked at guides, it was like an 8 out of 10. I personally didn't find it to be an 8. Everyone's different. And I did use like a really broken build towards the end, like for the final few missions. So you'd probably have an even easier time if you used the broken build the whole way through. I spiced it up. I wanted to try different like builds and stuff. Armored Core was something that I'd only ever played once back in the day, back on the PlayStation 2. That was the only one I ever played. I did need to get all of the parts though, and you need to play through the game. I think it was like 3 or 4 times doing different things to get different missions. It's quite complicated, so you definitely need to follow a guide. And then you also then need to go back and do every single mission again and get an S rank. Next up, we had Crisis Remastered. I did not enjoy this game, like, at all. I thought it was pretty crap, to be honest. Do plan on doing 2 and 3 at some point in the future in the hopes that them ones are better. There's a platinum. I also thought a lot of the trophies were really annoying as well. Like, some of the trophies were annoying. Luckily, though, for me, it was a short platinum, so it didn't take too long, thankfully, because I wasn't enjoying myself. Resident Evil 4. I think this one's up here because I'd already got the platinum for Resident Evil 4. There's no video for that, unfortunately, because I platinumed it before I started making videos. But yeah, I absolutely love pretty much every single Resident Evil game. I love every single one of them, so I do really want to get some kind of Resident Evil platinum on the channel. The problem is, because I'm such a big fan of Resident Evil, I think I've got most of them already. Maybe I need like the PS4 version of Resident Evil 5 and 6, and I think I might need the remaster of Resident Evil 1. So if I do, I might do all 3 of those on the channel at some point, but yeah. I can't really say anything negative at all about Resident Evil 4. It's just, it was an amazing game back in the day. It's still an amazing game now. It was, difficulty-wise, it wasn't too bad. Completing the main story on hardcore mode with an S plus rank is definitely not easy, but it's also not that difficult. I'd probably just give it like a 6 or a 7 out of 10 difficulty-wise. What I will say, though, is the reason it's a bit higher on the list up here is because I played the Separate Ways DLC, which I honestly thought was way harder than the base game to get this trophy here, Ada the S plus Spy. I did make it a lot harder for myself though, because in the video I actually said that the Chicago sweeper wasn't really that useful. I was very wrong. If you get this Chicago sweeper and use the token on it to fully max it out, you get unlimited ammo. And at the time I didn't know that, so I could have absolutely made this 10 times easier than it was. I didn't know it at the time, so I didn't do that. Yeah, if you do that now, definitely just upgrade the Chicago sweeper and use it, the token on that, because you'll have a way easier time than I did. I loved it regardless. GTA 3, the Definitive Edition. I love the GTA games. Every single GTA game I absolutely love. Even these Definitive Editions, even though they're definitely not the Definitive Edition, and they do definitely have a lot of issues. As for trophies to get the platinum in this, it's the usual. Go for 100%, which means getting, you know, doing taxi fares and all that crazy stuff. I've got a video if you want to see my platinum run for this one. I would definitely do it again. Remnant 2. This is one that I haven't uploaded yet. A game that I wouldn't recommend going for the platinum. The game itself is amazing. I absolutely love the game. Getting the platinum is super, super tedious towards the end. Aimlessly grind out XP for like 15 hours or something, 10, 15 hours at the end. It was so goddamn boring. The Crew Motorfest, I played way more of the game than I needed to. You can get the platinum in like 20 hours, but I ended up playing like 50 hours or something, 60 hours, because I just enjoyed it so much. A lot of the trophies are actually really fun. The only issue I had with the platinum trophy for this one was the festival fanfare. You needed to reach level 15. It doesn't actually register your level until the next season starts, which was really, really annoying. You can easily just do everything you need to do and then stop playing and then just pick up the game when the new season starts for that trophy. Definitely recommend this game. Even if you don't go for the platinum, I still recommend it because it's just such a fun game to play. Assassin's Creed Mirage. Really enjoyed this one as well. Kind of went back to the roots of Assassin's Creed. Again, I only know from like watching videos and stuff like that what the new Assassin's Creed games are like, because I haven't really played them. I think the newest one I played was like, what was it called? The one in France, was it? I think it was Unity. And when I played it, it was when it was new. And if anyone played Unity when that game it first came out, it was really glitchy. The frame rate was terrible. It had so many bugs and glitches, and it was not a fun experience. And that was the last time I actually played Assassin's Creed. So yeah, this one was definitely a throwback. As I said earlier, I do plan on going through all the Assassin's Creed games, so we'll get there at some point. Mirror's Edge Catalyst, this is one that I'm going to go back to. I think I unlocked, if I remember right, I read online that the servers were shutting down in December. I think they've already shut down now. So I went back to grab the only two online trophies just so I can actually get the platinum. So if you have a look here, these two, so you can see there, 2016 was when I originally played it and got a bunch of the trophies. And then I went back for these two. So get yourself a user-created BLE and complete a user-created time trial. These are the only two online trophies. And like I say, because the servers were shutting down in December, I wanted to get them two done. So the platinum wasn't impossible, which if you don't have those two trophies, the platinum, to my knowledge, is now impossible. Battlefield Hardline, this is up here because I ended up going back and doing a couple of the DLC trophies. Nothing really too exciting here. Immortals of Avium. This is actually, I feel like this is an underrated game. It's nobody talks about it, but it's actually a really good game. The Platinum Journey is pretty fun as well. There is a decent amount of collectibles towards the end. Yeah, really, really fun game. Check out the video if you're interested in that one. Mafia 2 Definitive Edition. This is actually my most popular video on the channel. I think it's got like 19k now or 20k, which I'm actually really happy about because I absolutely love Mafia 2. I love Mafia 1 as well. Mafia 3 is a game I really want to go to at some point in the future and get the platinum for, but I've heard a lot of terrible things about the achieving the platinum trophy in Mafia 3. Like if you turn off the game, the trophy progress like resets and stuff. So I'm not really sure how I'm going to go about doing that one. I'm sure I'll be able to figure it out. But Mafia 2, absolutely loved getting the platinum again. Video on the channel. Loved every moment. Well, I say every moment of getting the platinum. There's one thing I don't like about getting the platinum, which is the wanted posters. If you guys saw the video, you'll know that there's just way too many wanted posters. You can see there, find all wanted posters. If I remember right, it's like 180 or something. It's ridiculous. And it's probably the only real issue with getting the platinum overall. It's just way too many. DLCs, I plan on making a video about the DLCs, but they're kind of nothing too crazy. I got all of them in Joe's Adventures, but Jimmy's Vendetta, there's a trophy that I just refuse to get. I can easily get them, but I refuse to because you got to drive 1,000 miles, which doesn't sound like that much, I guess. I had a look online and it's basically about 15 hours of constant driving up and down the motorway. What? Who thought it would be a good idea and a fun trophy to have someone drive 15 hours up and down the motorway or just drive around for 15 hours? Who thought that was a good idea? Like, that's ridiculous. I think I played through the whole of the base game and I think I maybe only had like 300. And to make it even worse, those 300 miles that you drove in the base game don't count towards the 1,000 miles. It's ridiculous. It's absolutely ridiculous that they put this trophy in the game. And it's a bronze just to rub it in. And you can see there, ultra rare, 0.2. And it's ultra rare for a reason, because it is a big bloody waste of time. There is a glitch you can do where you can fall under the map and leave your console on for like 30 hours for it to do it. But if the game crashes, you're kind of screwed. So yeah, I just refuse to do such a boring, ridiculous trophy. Like, no, stop with trophies like that, developers. It's so bad. Next, Marvel's Spider-Man 2. I mean, what can you say that hasn't already been said? I think most of us have probably all done it as well. So yeah, really good. Concrete Genie. So Concrete Genie Call of the Sea, Lake, Unpacking, and The Artful Escape. All five of these are platinums that I did in my Can I Platinum 5 Games in 24 Hours challenge. And if you've seen that video, you'll already know I enjoyed all five of these. They were all really fun games to play and all really fun platinums as well. Yeah, I ended up finishing that challenge. So yeah, go check out the video for that one. It was really fun. So next we got the Crew Motorfest. Nothing to say here, it's the PS4 version. It Takes Two, still working on that one. EA Sports UFC 5. This is another one a little bit like Motorfest, where you can get all of the trophies in like 20 hours-ish, but then you need to wait for a pay-per-view to be able to get the final trophies, which is really annoying. So Far Cry New Dawn. So this is a video that's gonna be coming out in the future. Moving on to Call of Duty Modern Warfare 3. This one was an absolute grind. This took so goddamn long. I think this took me like 70 to 80 hours to get the platinum for this because of the kill 50,000 zombies, which is absolutely insane. That is such a huge number of zombies that you need to kill. You can see there as well, like all against all, ultra rare. 0.1 players earned. So this is probably going to be a platinum that's going to be pretty rare now for the end of days. Just getting a six-man squad together for the Orcus kill thing, even that was so goddamn annoying to do. This one as well was absolutely insane, which was to complete 5 contracts in a high threat zone in a single deployment. It was so goddamn difficult. I mean, there's a chance these might get easier with time because obviously it's a Call of Duty game. So the zombies mode, I know, will continue to get updated. When I did it at the time, it took ages and it was goddamn difficult. So yeah, that one was rough. So I've got Maneater on PS4 and PS5. I had the platinum on the PS4 version. I then went and did the Truth Quest DLC. Got all the trophies in there. And then I went onto the PS5 version. I think it auto-pops most of the trophies. I think there was a couple of things I needed to do. For the most part, it was an auto-pop. It's a really fun game and a really fun platinum. So if you haven't got the Maneater platinum, definitely go check it out. Grand Theft Auto Vice City, again, the definitive edition. This is the PS4 version. I think the GTA 3 one was the PS4 version as well. PS4 version. So the reason I did the PS4 versions is because for GTA 3, I already had like a lot of the trophies on the PS5 version. For Vice City, I already had the platinum on the PS5 version. GTA Vice City is my favorite GTA game, probably like one of my favorite games of all time. I can't say enough good things about GTA Vice City. Again, definitive edition, so it has its issues. I love the game and I cannot wait for GTA 6 knowing it's going to be back in Vice City. I'm so freaking hyped for that. I'll watch the trailer and you can kind of see some of the couple of familiar areas. So yeah, amazing. Kato, I think this is going to be part of my next 5 platinums challenge. Human Fall Flat, currently working on this. There's a lot of goddamn trophies though. You can see there I've got 71 of them. I think there's like 100. It's kind of crazy because there's a lot of DLC. They are all free though, which is really freaking cool. All the DLC for this game is free. So I've got 3 there that I need to do the DLCs, and then I've got the base game still to do. Rezogun is another one I'm working on. Kena, Bridge of Spirits. This is one that I went back to because I only needed 1 trophy, which was to beat the game on Master difficulty. And honestly, this was actually pretty difficult. This is definitely not an easy game. If you look at the game, you would think it was an easy game because of the art style. 100% I would recommend playing the game. Ark Survival Evolved. This was just one that I did recently. I just cheesed it. You can do console commands, so you can just like spawn enemies and stuff. It takes maybe like 2 hours to get the platinum. So yeah, nothing crazy there. The Walking Dead Destiny. So we're kind of getting a bit more up to date now with where I'm actually at with videos. Walking Dead. What can I say about Walking Dead Destinies that I haven't already said in the video? I mean, it's just a terrible game. I was excited to play the game and check it out because I really wanted it to be good, but it just isn't. It's just a crap game. And the only way I can recommend this game is if you just want to play a terrible game and maybe laugh at it a little bit. I really don't know. It's crap. Luckily, though, it's not a very long platinum. Conan Exiles, this was another one that you can cheese. Five Nights at Freddy's, Help Wanted. I actually really, really enjoyed getting this platinum. There was one or two areas in the game that were really difficult, but overall, super fun platinum, and I really, really enjoyed it. I was pleasantly surprised by how good this actually was and how much I enjoyed it. Go check out the video, it's a good one. All right, so Divine Knockout, PS4 and PS5 version. You auto-pop whichever version you want, to be honest. Most games, to auto-pop the platinum, you normally have to play the PS4 version, and then the PS5 version auto-pops. Because of that, most of the time, I just don't auto-pop. As much as I enjoy getting trophies, I enjoy playing games more. You know what I mean? So you can play a lot of the time, like I say, you can play the PS4 version, auto-pop the PS5, but if the game's got a PS5 version, I'm just going to play the PS5 version. I don't really care about getting two platinums in that way. But with this one, you can play the PS5 version and then auto-pop the PS4 version. So it's all good. The Finals, that's a new free-to-play that's come out. Probably never going to get the platinum in this game because the requirements are absolutely ridiculous. There's so many trophies in here that just you need to be so lucky just to get. And then there's some that are just insane grinds. Like, I think you need to win altogether 450 matches. Insane. Probably never going to get the platinum on that. Thank you so very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. Let me know, what platinums are you currently working on? How many platinums did you get this year? I want to know all that kind of stuff because it's super cool to see what my community is getting up to as well. I've been Mr. Leaning. Consider subscribing for more videos. And until next time, I'll see you all in the new year.